So please confirm when it is will be visible to you.
Yes, it's visible, yes.
It's visible to you.
Mm-hmm.
So today I have taken a brief about DevOps only. And from mm-hmm. tomorrow I will start with virtualization and other things. Okay.
Okay.
Here in today's agenda, I will cover what is DevOps, why we need DevOps, who has developed this history of DevOps, then Lean, ITIL and Agile model, DevOps stakeholders and DevOps goals, then what are the important terminologies, DevOps perspective, DevOps and Agile, tools and configuration management and continuous integration and deployment. So we will go in depth about the DevOps different themes, what is this, and about configuration management and continuous integration and deployment. We will just have an intro type. Going okay. forward, I will use the tools which you have given in your requirements. So by the tools we give. So today's session, there is no practical and hands-on on today's session. But yes, from tomorrow onwards, we will do the practical part also. Because today's part is only related to DevOps.
Okay.
Okay. So, and so this is about, so can we begin now?
Oh, sure.
Now the question start, what is DevOps? Okay. So if we see a traditional ways of working when it was started IT, so when it was there was a waterfall models where what is happening? Dev team and ops team is working in silos. Okay. So what is happening? When the customer send a requirement to when the organization get a requirement from the customers, so what they are doing? The business analyst was there, they are in contact with the customers, and then they take the requirements, then they pass the requirements to the technical development team. They check the requirements, whatever their doubts, then they go back. So development is taking place when the developer is working, no testing team is involved. And when development is done, then it will be given to the testing team. And then when testing is done and everything is fine, then it will be moved to the operations. So this was a traditional ways of working for DevOps. But with the with a new technologies coming, with the change in the market, so whenever it is so what the customer needs, so there a need comes. So what is happening in traditional, the feedback which is being given to the received by the developer, once the complete development done, testing done, and then when it goes for with the customer, then they got the feedback. So then they have to start again. So it was taking time, but now with the emerging technologies and the present scenarios, customer needs immediate feedback. Customer needs something which is immediate market, faster to the market and thing, and there was a lot of competition. So what?
Okay.
So what the business expects? So business expects stabilize, that is agility, quicker go to market, real-time feedback and analysis, faster development, quality service delivered, and simplified functions. So in traditional, this is not because there is no agility. So from there, the word agility comes. So what is agility? Agility is that it will be divided into a small chunks, and then it will be done, and immediately it will be given, and immediate feedback it has been come. So agility is being used in development, not in operations. So here a question comes, when agility is there, which is giving us a faster to the market, because when in agility it is some and immediate feedback is there, then what is the need requirement of the DevOps? Why the term DevOps comes? So here it is a point. So we will take it for later on, why the terms DevOps comes. So agility is there. Now, but the due to traditional, what the business is getting? Business is getting slow releases. Once the development and then the release is done. And low CSAT, customer satisfaction. Less market share. There is a high dependency. Dependency means When the developer has worked, then the testing will start, and after testing, the operations will start. So there is a high risk and there are more complexities.
Mm-hmm.
So now, today, if we see, we have most of the organization have tools, processes, and people. So what is lacking? These tools, process, and people are called investments. These are investments. But the organization lacks, what's the organization? Tool synchronization between tools, process, and people.
Mm-hmm.
So this DevOps comes, so now what is it? It is being a complete synchronization. Complete things are there. All are in collaborations.
Mm-hmm.
Are you got any? So it's clear now till this point. Can we move further? So
this Yeah.
So this is what we have in there. So now it comes DevOps. So DevOps, if we say DevOps is a process first and then automation next. Why we say it process first? Because when we apply a DevOps, DevOps means that Dev and Ops are working in a total collaboration with each other. As soon as there a continuous thing, is going, as soon as developers check in, it goes for testing, and as soon as so in that state, if there is any issue, it goes back to the developer, then developers again. So there we have a gated check-ins in between. So gated check-ins, that immediate feedback is going to the developer. Developer has not to wait for the complete testing to be completed, and then he will receive a feedback of when it will be go. So when everything is fine, it will be deployed, it will go to the customer. Customer immediately send the feedback. So this is a complete, we call it as a pipeline. So if you see, we have continuous integration, then we have continuous delivery, that is and then we have a continuous improvement. So this is a complete DevOps process. So what is happening? We are having agile mode. In agile mode, what we are doing, we are having a short sprint, 2 week sprint, or 2 weeks sprint, and we have, after completion of sprint, there is a complete analysis of the sprint in one meeting, and we take a feedback from there and then continues. Then after, if you see, here is a continuous scrum, agile development, then continuous integration, after testing and deployment. So this continuous testing and deployment comes to an agile delivery. Then a continuous feedback, and this will be a agile ALM. So now it's, so this is what is for DevOps process. So this is an overview of it, why we need a DevOps. We move further. Hello.
Yes, yes, please.
Okay. Yeah, I just thought. So what we say that a DevOps in short is a development and operations. So development and operation are in sync. They are not in a different. They are in sync with each other. So there is a collaboration between it. Now, as soon as the developers do, other parties are also being. So in a DevOps process, all the parties are being involved from the beginning. It is not that first, as we in traditional form, what we have seen that development is being done, only developers and business analyst is there. Tester comes later on, and then it goes to the operation. But now from in DevOps practice, we create a process, we create a complete process, and then we, so all the teams are being involved. Martin, I am hearing some background noise.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so.
Yeah, sorry about that. I put it on mute.
No issues. Okay. So now this is an overview of DevOps. So we have different stages of complete SDLC in DevOps. That is create, plan, release, configure, monitor, package, and verify. So all the devs that is development is in an agile relationship, and then is it includes the development phase. If we see here, it is a development phase. So development phase is having plan, create, verify, and package. Once this is done, then it will go for release, configure, and monitor. Okay, so development is doing, so it is, if you see here, these are not our silos entities. We are in collaboration with each other. So as on plan, create, so ops team is involved from the stages of plan, create, verify, and package. So when in release, if we face any issues, it goes back to the team, and then whatever it is there, it comes to this. So it is a continuous process. Continuous process. We have a continuous deliveries, continuous releases. So even a continuous feedback is being given to the developers. So it is that immediate feedback is there. So all the whatever the modification is required is being done. Is clear? Hello?
Yes, very clear.
Okay. Yeah. Now we will move to history of DevOps. So DevOps is being invented by a Patrick DevOps. He is a Belgium consultant and a project manager. He's an agile practitioner. So when he's working, he found that, yes, we have used an agility in development. But people in development are working in an agile mode, and they are doing. But we are not involving operation tasks in our agile mode. So once its operation is being there separately, there development is there, then operations is there. So he just thought of a process that why not we collaborate with dev and ops, and then we can. And then it will be a beneficial for us, and it will be a good for this. So that's why it blends us lean thinking and agile, and with the agile philosophy. So that's why the DevOps terms comes there. He has given a complete thing in his presentation, 10 deploys per day. That is dev and ops in cooperation with this work. So this is about how the DevOps comes.
Okay.
Now we have a DevOps stakeholders. So we cannot say that it is a separate thing, only development and ops teaming in one. Because as in the first phase, I said that DevOps is a process first and automation second. So whenever in any organization we are going to implement DevOps, we have to have a green signal from the management also. And in this, even the product team the product team is the main stakeholders in this. That is marketing, product management, engineering, sales, and project management. All are being involved. So these all are the stakeholders. And then it will move to dev, ops, and QA. So if we say for DevOps stakeholders are marketing team, engineering team, sales team, project management, and product management team is also being involved.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because I will give you a scenario. Whenever when we are working on, as an organization, we get a project to work for a customer on to implement a DevOps. So it is not straight. It will be our sales team who is being in touch with them, with the customer, and they take their what their ask is. Then after that, it comes, we provide that what we have the capability, how we can implement them on the basis of their requirements, which we call an RFP phase. So here sales team product team, engineering team, and project management team is all being involved when they present the solutions. And then once it will comes, when the solution comes to us, then the implementation comes. So the initial thing is being done by this. So all these are the stakeholders.
Okay.
Is it clear?
Yes, very clear.
Therefore, we say that stakeholders are there, and then we when we say that stakeholders also involve the customers, complete engineering team, and system, because as DevOps is a process first. So before, we cannot go and implement DevOps directly. What we do, we have to assess their ecosystem. First, we will study their ecosystem. So whenever we are going to implement a DevOps, whether it is for an application deployment, whether it is for an operations task, what we do, we have to study their ecosystem. Ecosystem means what are their processes, what are their tools, and how, whether they are using the automation completely or there are some manual tasks. We will check their pain areas. Okay. We will get their pain areas, and after getting their pain areas, we present our recommendations that how now we will going to implement DevOps in their ecosystem. What the changes are being required to be managed, how we will do, what the tools we are using, before implementing, we will have a green signal from the customer management also, whether customer is ready to use new tools, existing tools, and a comp, or they want that we can implement using their only existing tools. They are not, because some customers are not ready to invest more and they will not go for it. So here we checking with the customer and what the security they have. Suppose it is a healthcare or a banking domain. Now in healthcare and banking, Martin, I will need a 2 minutes break. I have to bring a water because I was just feeling.
Okay, sure, no problem.
So sorry for this.
No, thank you.
Yeah, I'm back. Sorry for this interruption.
No problem at all. Okay.
So these are the different stakeholders. So now in our, these all work in together. So whenever we are going to implement DevOps in any organization, so we need some DevOps architects, we need some DevOps engineer to work on it. So architects are being for designing the complete implementation strategies, complete DevOps roadmap, and how and design the complete CI/CD pipeline. Because what we say CI/CD, continuous integration and continuous delivery pipeline.
So the architects are from from our team or the companies.
That is, suppose it is from our team. It is not from the customer.
Okay.
So for the customer for which we are implementing, so these, they are from our team. So we deployed architect, and then we deployed engineers also. Architect is doing assessment. So what we do in assessment, we know their ecosystem. So we take here some applications as a baseline. So we decide on this. So what if there are frequent releases of some application. So we take their application and the environment, and then we go through for the doing the assessment. So assessment gives us the thing that at what level the customer is on DevOps, and on that basis we can give them the implementation strategies. So these are the things.
Okay.
Now the question comes, why DevOps? Something I have. So if we see a pre-DevOps processes, okay, we have developers, we have software, environment, and services, and the requirements. Okay. Mm-hmm. So now this is an operation. So this is a pre-DevOps processes. Now even in this, what they are, the softwares are taking 2 to 6 weeks, API integration 2 weeks, infra takes 2 to 8 weeks. So it was taking too much time. If you see here, the service software development 2 to 6 weeks, and deploying a software take 2 to 3 weeks, API integration takes 2 weeks, and infra takes 2 to 8 weeks. So this was taking too much time. So what's now here, what is happening? Developers are working, they are releasing to QA quality, and quality is taking 2 to 4 weeks. Once the testing is done between 2 to 4, 6, then deployment request is being given to the release manager. After this testing completed, QA is completed, then the deployment request is being to the release manager, and then deployment is being done by the operations. So this was a pre-DevOps process. So now what we are doing, then QA, pre-prod, and development are being deployed on this. So if a defect comes, then it again goes to the developers. Then developers make the changes. Then this QA testing is being done. Okay. So what is happening? It was taking too much time. Only when it was reaching here, then only defects is coming, and then it is going back to the developer, and the complete cycle will taking again a place.
Mm-hmm.
So this was a thing. So it comes that why not in between we have our gated check-ins. Yeah, gated check-ins means as soon as a developer commits, okay, as soon as developer commits. So he commits in a source code management. When he commits, information is given. So we, and then it will be checked. The unit testing is being done. Suppose at that place, unit testing. I will just use a whiteboard to explain you this.
Okay. Are you going to share the slides?
Yeah, I will share the slides.
Excellent, thank you.
Now, if you see, this is a development.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and instead of this, I will just use this pen. Okay, so this is dev. So once it developer to check in, okay, developer has done a check in. So once developer has done a check in, so here unit testing is being done. So if there was any issue, it will go just back to the developer.
Okay.
So with with the tool, unit testing is being done, it will just go and it goes to the developer again. He make the changes, he does commit. Now suppose it is clear, so then it will move to other part, that is for the code quality analysis.
Okay.
So code quality analysis, everything is okay, then it will move further. Otherwise it will again go back to the developers with the recommend, with all the issues, errors, what is there. So he will make the changes and again it follows. So here what is happening? So if you see in this, developer is getting the information at the end. Okay, the developer is getting information at the end. But now with the use of DevOps, we are using tools or with it, immediate feedback is given to developers. So what it is, we have not to wait till the end. We have not to wait till the end, and it will just goes back to them. Okay, so in this, so what is there? No collaboration. So pre-DevOps, there is no collaboration between Dev, QA, Ops. They do not interact with each other. Develop, whenever any requirements come, developers has developed their code, then they have sent to the QA, then tester being involved. They are not in collaboration. They are not talking to each other. They are working in a silos.
Mm-hmm.
And developers are using their own tool. Testers are using on old tool. Operations are using on. So this integrated tools and processes. Everyone has their own processes, and those processes are not being integrated with each other.
Okay.
Most of the task is manual. They have a limited automations. Therefore, what is the impact of this? We have a delayed time to production. The what's the suppose a request has come, it was developed, it takes times, and when it was developed and it releases to the customer, a new change has come because there was a change in the market, there was changes. So what is happening after then, again the changes is being done. So it is not a faster to the market. So to overcome all these process things, this term dev, the process of dev and ops, philosophy. DevOps is a philosophy. So a philosophy, a culture. So a culture and a philosophy of DevOps has come in existence.
Mm-hmm.
Is it clear?
Yes, please. It's very clear.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. So pre-DevOps, they are blaming each other. What they are doing, they are blaming each other. Ops is saying, there is an issue in your development. And Dev is saying, no, we have developed here. There is an issue in your processes. So they are blaming each other.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the typical pain points. What is happening due to this in silos, taking time and blaming each other? It is a budget over there. There are long testing cycles. There is a lower environment build out. Even the environment, a small environment takes a long time. And even the operations skills are not being supported with new modern platforms. There is a collaboration issues all over. So these are the typical pain points which are present in pre-DevOps processes.
Mm-hmm.
Now question comes, why DevOps? So till now it's clear, or you need something more?
No, it's clear, very clear. So
okay,
far, so
thank you. Okay. So now if we see why DevOps, because if you see in a change environment, now the people are using Facebook, Twitter, and WhatsApp, and there is a massive use of it. So these are our social media is there. Now everyone needs it a quick update. So, and what they want, whenever there was a quick update, there will be no downtime. Earlier, what is happening whenever in a pre-DevOps stage, whenever there was a new deployment, the application is being down and the deployment is done and then it will be up. So they, but now in present scenario, this is not possible. People want that. If you see in a Facebook, new features are coming, but there is no downtime. This is zero downtime. So that's why time to value, deploy faster, deploy often. Developer self-service. That is, allow developer to build and test against the product-like systems. So they are doing. There is an increase in the quality. The cost is reduced. There is a because with the tools, there is a increase in our test coverage. And even increased environment utilization. We are creating a virtualized development and test environments. We are creating dev and test environments and then moving it to pod or non-pod. And then even what is their virtual environments, we can put it down. Once we are not required, we can shut it down.
Okay.
And there is a minimum, in some cases, there will be minimum downtime. Otherwise, application is up and deployment is done. Even the defect resolution is also good, because what is happening? Immediate information is being received and immediate the implementation is there. So that is immediate feedback. So whatever there was an issue is being resolved immediately. Dev and Ops are working in collaboration. So these are the needs for DevOps.
Okay.
Today's session will be a theoretical session. So yeah. If you need any break in between, just let me know.
Okay. Oh, no. Yeah, I'm good.
Okay.
And if you need any break, feel free, to take a break if you want to.
No. It's okay. It is my morning.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, you are in India?
Yeah, I am in India.
Ah, okay. I thought you are here in the US.
No. It's morning. It's 6. It is now 7 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, too early for you.
Give me 1 minute. I think somebody has come. I will just check it out. Give me 1 minute. Okay. Sorry. Okay. Hello. Yes. Okay. So this is about a strategy map.
Okay.
So if you see in this DevOps strategy map, So now the questions comes, do we really need DevOps? Do we have problem? If yes, how to get it out? So how we come to know about the problems and bottlenecks which we are having? So what we do, we, as I have told you, we do the assessment. Mm-hmm. When we do the assessment, so we identify the application. Now we don't take any applications. We see the applications which have frequent releases. So we take those applications. What is the application architecture? How it's working? What is the process being used by this? So from there, we find the bottleneck.
Okay.
And after finding the bottleneck and the problems, that is the pain areas. In the pain areas, what we see? What are their manual processes? Suppose when they are using, what are their manual processes? How we can automate their processes? What are changes we can bring in their process? New changes in their process. Suppose a company is not following agile completely. Okay. So when they are not following agile completely, what we are doing? We are asking them to follow agile in all phases. So this is how we plan and recommend them. So how can we solve these problems? How can we accomplish our mission? That we create a plan of action with the timelines. Perform the gap analysis. We estimate the investments, because we provide with the customer that yes, There, these are the gap analysis. You have these manual tasks. Now we have to automate. And to automate, we have to use a tool. So what is the pricing of the tools and all. So, and then the rollout. So this is the way how we work on a DevOps.
Okay.
So now who are our customers? What do they value? So yes, of course, the leadership is a, because if we don't get a green signal from the leadership, we are not able to implement it. So customers are the leadership, the leadership of the customer. And what they value, they need the speed and the quality. Whatever the work they need that, yes, it will be immediate being done and with the quality, that not quality will, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So now the question arises that when we are using DevOps, because when we are implementing DevOps, we are making investment in that. The tools being used and everything, the people to be bring. So will this bring in value to our organization? What are the associated benefits? So whenever customer sees, yes, he wants the benefits. He wants that what the value his organization will get. So what will happen when we are using DevOps? Faster time to market. We have an asset utilization, because what we are seeing that before DevOps, people are using tools, but they are using, sometimes they are using tools in silos. They are not continuously using it. So in some phases they are using tools. So they have the tools in their organization, but they are not using it. Suppose, let's take an example. A customer is having an agile mode of working. Okay. So in agile mode of working, they are using the tools like Jira or something like this. But people are not changing what they are doing. They are following their old processes, that is Excel sheets and this. They are maintaining all their data in Excel sheet. They are not using a tool. So asset is there, but it is not being utilized. So when we have seen their processes, yes, they are not using it. They are doing it manually. Let us bring it in our automation there. Let they create whatever the task is there. Let they create epic story or something in Jira. And for tracking, instead of manual tracking, it will then automated tracking. So okay, it will bring a customer satisfaction also. It will increase an employee morale also. So these are the values to the organization and associated benefits.
Okay, nice.
Okay, thank you. So now the next thing is about the SDLC model. What is Lean, ITL and Agile? So Agile is a approach. Agile is an approach where for our software delivery processes, where we are doing the work in an incremental manner. That is, when the project is started, we are not taking a complete way. We have divided the project task into a sprint, a small sprint, that is 2 weeks sprint. So once the sprint is complete, and then at the end, it is being incremented. So this way, it is an incremental approach.
Okay.
Okay. Let me give you an example how the Agile works. So in Agile, we have a multi-discipline persons. In Agile, when we create an Agile team, there is an Scrum Master, there will be developers, there will be testers. And now with the, because in earlier when Agile is being used only in development phase, Agile is not being used in operation phase. So what is happening in Agile phase? In development phase, we have developers, testers, business analysts, all are in one group. We have a sprint, and we have a and in that they have a daily stand-up call at the start of the day. What the use of this daily stand-up call? It gives a that where they are standing, what the issues they are facing. They discuss their issues at their point at what they are facing, how to be, and what are the suggestions from others. So in this way they are working, and then they are delivering the software to the operations team. So when they are working in a sprint, that yes, this feature is to be covered in a sprint. Suppose application which is to be developed has four features. first feature will become covered in the first sprint and this. And when it is being covered and done, then they integrate the complete features and then given to the operations team. So now after sprint also, they have a complete presentation of the first sprint and they do the root cause analysis. They study that what are the new learnings from there and how we can implement in the second sprint. So this is a agile mode of working.
Okay, what's the meaning of SDLC?
SDLC, Software Development Lifecycle.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so software development lifecycle, I will just show you in a whiteboard, which will give.
Okay.
Okay. Paint only. So, we have a requirement phase.
Mm-hmm.
In SD, requirement phase, that is.
Yeah, I'm not seeing the whiteboard.
My whiteboard. Oh, sorry. Okay. I will just stopping the sharing and then I will, because I have done only, okay, you're not seeing my whiteboard, no issues. My okay. PowerPoint is there. I will just give it in a new slide, blank slide. I hope this will be visible to you. It is visible, yes. Blank slide, yes.
Yes.
So now what we are having, yeah, it will be good for you also. So now we have a requirement phase. Okay.
Hmm.
Requirement phase. Requirement phase, complete SDLC. Then we have a development.
Mm-hmm.
Because this will give you a clear picture of SDLC. Development. Requirements comes. Sorry, not development. Once the requirement comes, then. Sorry for this. Then we have a requirement analysis. So customer gives the requirement. Customer gives the requirement. Then customer gives the requirement. Then requirement to the business analyst. Requirement analysis is being done. That what is the requirement? They will say, suppose a customer has given a requirement. Now what with their talk with the customer, the business analyst present the what are the features to be required, what is to be developed. Then a development team comes. Okay. Then the development team comes. Now they develop. After development team, it goes for QA. So here, testing. Testing is being done.
Okay.
With development, unit testing is being done. Then it goes where the functional performance and all testing is being done. After that, it will go for UAT, user acceptance testing. And then, so this is complete development lifecycle. The software is developed. So in this way, it works. So this is SDLC.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, oh, welcome. So lean is a methodology. Lean is a methodology to deliver more value by eliminating a waste. So that means that using, we are not doing anything. So this word lean is come from a Toyota manufacturing company. So when a Toyota manufacturing company are working, so that they say that why don't we bring such methodology that we can deliver a more value and even we cannot make any waste of the things. The things will not be, we will reuse it. Reusability of this is called a lead. So suppose now in IT, when we develop a code, so the code in Lean, the code is developed in such a way that it can be reused for the similar other things also. Only after making a small changes, we can make it out for the next usage. So this is called a lean.
Okay.
Okay. ITIL. ITIL is a process. It is a good practices for application support. And it is not a framework. It is a continuous improvement for the ongoing services. It is not a finished software. This is for operation. ITIL is being used for operations. When we are doing operations, then how we can improve the operations? Suppose we are doing it, now we find that there is a gap. So how we can improve this gap, we can remove this gap and improve our processes. So this is an ITIL, that service desk processes. So this is was ITIL.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Now let's move to DevOps and Agile. Because DevOps and Agile, so stakeholder communication in a typical IT process is just like customer plus software requirement, developer plus tester, and operation and IT infrastructure. Now, there is a gap between them, when they work, then after that, as we have seen earlier. So to fill this gap, Agile comes. Now what Agile comes, now the developer and tester are being involved from the requirement phase only. Earlier, what is happening? The tester and developers are being involved. The VAs do the requirement analysis and then they give it to developers. They are not involved with the customer and in collecting the software requirements. But here in this case, with the agility, by bringing a agile, the developers and testers are also involved from the beginning. So this has filled the gap, because what is happening, customer has given software requirement, business analyst has done, and on their basis with their interaction with the customer, they have given the requirement to the developer. When developer does, and then the customer says, no, I don't want this. I asked this, but you have given, I asked A and you have given me B. So to fill this gap, what they have done, they have involved the developer and tester from the beginning of the cycle. The software development side. So now what the developers will say, yes, now suppose the customer has given their requirement. Yes, they want an application A. It may have these features and these features will be integrated with each other and in this way. Now developer and tester are there. So they say, yes, it will be done, but not in this way in required. We can do like this. So at the beginning only,